With the 2021 Emilia-Romagna Grand Prix coming up, I wanted to get on the hype train of views, but create more distinctive content. So instead of just reviewing F1 cars at Imola, I wanted to introduce the Indy car to Imola and the world. Now, on this preview flying lap of the circuit, I made a major error to employ the use of harder compound tires, which provide much less grip than compared to the soft compound tires. So in this lap, there are a lot of corners you can take flat with faith in the car and the track, which we'll get into when the time comes. As we reach the heavy braking zone into turn one, you want to brake when the inside of the track starts to widen up slightly. Then you can go through turn two with half throttle on a confident lap, and then through turn three you get onto full throttle, but just make sure on exit that you don't dip a tire too far on the grass. The braking zone for turn four isn't too heavy, so you want to carry as much speed as you dare, but at the same time set up the more major braking zone of turn five, for which you need to slow down a lot. Out of that mock chicane is a short blast to the famous hairpin where Michael Schumacher went blind, according to Juan Pablo Montoya. Hopefully Mick retains his eyesight on exit and makes a late apex to get as much speed as possible on the straight into an uphill braking zone for Pirotella, a corner at which you don't want to take too many liberties with track limits at. The next two right-hand corners are similar to the Degna corners at Suzuka, carrying as much speed as you can through the first one and braking hard for the more severe turn in for the second one. Coming out of the double right-handers is a short straight, which is abruptly ended by a very tight chicane that on Project Cars 2 has very unforgiving inside curbs. In real life, however, these sausage curbs were replaced by more traditional curbs. Now coming into the final section of the track and the last major braking zone of this lap, you want to be very cautious under braking with a slight bump at the beginning of the braking zone, but on exit you should abuse the exit curb onto the final major corner of the lap and exit in a similar style. Now as we approach the line, aim to reduce the transit time by as much as possible by cutting those inside sections of the track between the track and the pit wall as much as you dare without track extending, and that's a very scruffy lap of Imola, but you get the gist. Now let's see how closely these Indy cars can race here at Imola in a four lap race. As the lights are out and we're underway with a pretty decent start, we take the outside line on the grass to avoid the slower grid of cars in the middle, yet we still make a bit of a contact going into the Tamburello chicane, but nonetheless keep a wheel on the track to get up into P13 and on the heels of the points, paying positions out of the Tamburello. And with a good exit, using the softer compound tires, we take two more cars, making it three wide momentarily on the approach into Villeneuve. And through Villeneuve itself, we pick up another position to get into P10 and into the points. We initially want to follow the traffic and take the racing line through the hairpin, but quickly dart to the inside to dive bomb P9 and 8, although the red target sponsored car gets a better exit than me, so we get a net gain of one position. We try to overtake him around the outside of Pirotella, but we don't take a wide enough line, causing us to crash into the back of him into the corner, losing our speed and nearly getting overtaken. We try to stick behind the target car as much as possible through the double left-handers, but losing the rear end on exit of the second one meant that I had lost my advantage to him in front and get overtaken, drop to 9th. Now, you could say it's terrible racing because I'm not able to follow as well as the AI. That's more because of the fact that I can't follow the AI, meaning that they take impossible lines that have different braking characteristics than compared to a human. They brake very well into some corners with a defined racing line, and sometimes they're very unsure and not confident going into corners, and it's very difficult to telegraph when or when not the AI is going to do something or not. Which is why I usually crack under pressure and go wide, like at the end of the third lap, going outside of the white lines, which we can't wane off, so we get a 1 second penalty, which catches me off guard through the hairpin, causing me to lose the rear end on exit with the front left getting stuck on the inside curb on the final lap, allowing the guys behind to catch me up. But at least that was the final lap, so I've survived the pressure from behind, but not unscathed, with a 1 second penalty pushing me down from P9 to P11, just outside the points, just showing how modern cars that can follow really well can have very close racing here at Imola. Before I close out, thank you guys so much for 50 subs. Now we're targeting 100 subs, and because of this, I thought I might as well space out my uploads to allow me to make more quality content than compared to before. And I've been working on a few projects in the background that will be on YouTube very soon. If you like this video, be sure to like it. And if you want to see more content like this, be sure to subscribe. You won't regret it. And as always, I'll see you whenever I'll see you. Peace!